everybody, Dr. Joe Galati, and in today's video, what I want to do is talk about a very important part of caring for people with liver disease, and that is having a discussion about the MELD score, M-E-L-D. That stands for Model for End-Stage Liver Disease. Now, this was originally devised in the early 2000s as a way of predicting survival in patients with liver disease that were going to have a certain procedure done called a TIPS procedure. And that TIPS procedure stands for a transjugular intrahepatic portosystemic shunt. It's a procedure that radiologists do in most facilities, and it is done to treat and manage patients that have large amounts of ascites, which is swelling in their abdomen, or if they are bleeding from esophageal or gastric varices. And so this MELD score calculation was created to try to predict which one of these patients going for a TIPS procedure was going to do well, which were going to do poorly. And in the context of liver disease, doing poorly means you're probably not going to survive. And so this was a prognostic model of trying to determine which patients were better off for these procedures and which were not so good for these procedures. And like so many things in medicine, the application of this MELD score calculation was then looked at for other situations. And the first that came to be really was to try to figure out if the MELD score in any way predicted survival while waiting for a liver transplant. And so what happened around 2002, the MELD score replaced the prior scoring system to determine who was going to get a liver transplant. And so that is the standard of where we are at now. Now, with regard to our patients and their MELD score, keep in mind that the MELD score is calculated, and all of you can go to a number of online MELD score calculators, and I'll be listing them here, that you can calculate your own MELD score. Now, the original MELD score only included three laboratory values. The current MELD score that we've been using for the past 4 years added the sodium, the salt in a person's blood. So right now, to calculate your MELD score, you are going to have and know your serum sodium, your creatinine, which is a measure of kidney function, your bilirubin, the total bilirubin, and the INR. And that's a laboratory value that evaluates how well your blood clots. So by knowing these four blood values, having the calculator, you can calculate your MELD score. Now, the other thing about the MELD score is there is a question that they ask if you are on one of these sites, asking whether or not the person has been receiving dialysis or not. If the person is receiving dialysis, you click that particular button, the serum creatinine automatically goes to 4, and your MELD score increases. And so this system is built in to give a advantage to patients that are on dialysis, because we know patients on dialysis with cirrhosis tend to have a worse outcome. And so the MELD score on purpose is going to be raised. By raising the MELD score, the likelihood of getting transplanted goes up and your survival goes up. So the system, for the most part, works very well. Now, the MELD score can be calculated between roughly 6 and 40. Now, I have a table here that shows you as the MELD score increases, the survival goes down. And so you could see here that as somebody at one extreme, if the MELD score is 40, their 3-month survival is going to be less than 20%. That is quite poor. But you could see if somebody's MELD score is about 15, their three-month survival is nearly 100%. These people are going to do very well. And as you can see, as the MELD score increases from 20 to 30 to 40, the survival goes down. Now, around the United States, and certainly in Europe, where they are doing transplants, different regions, different parts of the country have different MELD scores that they are transplanting at. Here in the southwestern United States, we are transplanting in the 28 and above MELD score range. There are other parts of the country, because of all sorts of different factors, that they are transplanting at lower MELD scores. Patients are a bit more healthy. Likewise, there are parts of the country, major metropolitan areas, where the MELD score is higher, and they are considered a high MELD score area. Now, what I've done as an example here, and I will outline, is show you that when there are changes in your blood chemistries, changes in the sodium, changes in the bilirubin or creatinine, your MELD score will go up. And so the first situation I have is where the serum sodium is 140, the creatinine is 0.5, which is normal, the INR is 1.0, and they get a calculated MELD score of 6. That's pretty low. These are relatively normal labs. Now, if you change things, and again, this is strictly for example to show you, as your blood work changes, your MELD score will go up. So if you keep the serum sodium at 140, you increase the creatinine to 1.5, meaning you're losing a little bit of kidney function, realizing that loss of kidney function is associated with increased mortality, increased death. And if we keep the bilirubin slightly elevated at 1.0, INR slightly elevated at 1.2, the MELD score increases to 12. Now, still, that is a pretty good MELD score. You're not in any urgent need of transplant, but you can see as the creatinine goes up, as the bilirubin goes up, the MELD score is starting to climb. Now, the third calculation. Serum sodium is still at 140. Serum creatinine still at 1.5. But let's see what happens if the bilirubin goes from 1.0 to 2.0. Keeping the INR at 1.2, the MELD score is now 15. Let's take it one more step. We're going to drop the serum sodium to 130. So from 140 to 130. And we do know that as the serum sodium decreases, mortality goes up, more complications. We're going to keep the creatinine, the kidney function, at about 1.5. We're going to keep the bilirubin at 2. The INR still at 1.2. But here, the MELD score jumps to 21. Okay? Another manipulation of the numbers. Keeping the serum sodium at 130. The creatinine is up to 1.9. So it goes from 1.5 to 1.9. The total bilirubin goes to 2.5. 2 to 2.5. And the INR increases slightly to 1.5. So all of the chemistry slightly worsening. When you calculate the MELD score, it is 25. Now, suppose that person now needs dialysis. Their kidneys are failing. They're accumulating fluid. Toxins are not being released from the body through urine. If you click the tab that says the person is now receiving dialysis, the MELD score will jump up to 31. There is a very high likelihood that in most parts of the country, this person is going to be a higher priority for liver transplant. Now, the other option, if the numbers are getting worse, but they're not on dialysis, okay? So the serum sodium is 130. Creatinine is still elevated at 1.9. But this time, the bilirubin is 5. They are jaundiced at this point. Their skin and their eyes are yellow. The INR, 1.5, their MELD score is 27. That is without dialysis. So you could see the message here is that the MELD score is going to be tied to those four lab values, the bilirubin, the serum sodium, the creatinine, and the INR. Whether or not you are receiving dialysis will be another sort of wild card that will bump up the MELD score and your likelihood of getting a transplant. And so hopefully all of you will have a little bit more of a better understanding of how the MELD score is calculated. Now, the one thing here, we're dealing with four laboratories, very black and white. There is no interpretation or subjectivity of these labs. Your bilirubin is 2.7. Your bilirubin is 5. There's no interpretation. You don't get any points for feeling bad. At this point in time, you do not get any points for having hepatic encephalopathy. Now, there are mechanisms within the system, and I'll talk about this on another video, where you can petition the regional board of the United Network for Organ Sharing to get extra bonus points. We call these exception points. If your MELD score, as calculated, is not high enough to get transplanted, but yet you are in and out of the hospital, you're having a very hard time with your liver disease, you're ill, quality of life is very poor. So there are these opportunities to get exception points, which again is a completely different, more complicated topic that we can talk about. So the take-home message, number one, understand the four laboratory values that calculate the MELD score. Number two, realize that as the MELD score goes up from 15 to 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, the survival goes down. Allocation of donor organs when they're available are based on the MELD score. The other point is based on where you live in the United States, you may be in a high MELD score area or region or a lower MELD score region. And so where you live will depend on how important that MELD score is. The other idea here, which is most important, is that as you get more sick, unfortunately, these blood tests become more abnormal, more really distant from what the normal range is. The MELD score is going to go up, and then your priority for transplant goes up. And so myself and all of my colleagues here realize that in order to get transplanted, you have to get more sick and have more abnormal laboratories. So thank you very much for looking at this video. Hopefully it will shed some light on the MELD score process and all of you having a better understanding. Of course, if you have any questions at all, you could send me a message through texasliver.com or our other website, drjoegalati.com. Have a great day. Stay well. Make sure you know what your MELD score is. Always ask for it when you see your doctor. Take care. We'll be right back.